World Cup of Motorsport and a return visit to the track at Taupo that was developed with A1 GP in mind for the 2007 season. Let's take a look at how the grid lines up then for this feature race. And it is France on pole position after a long drought of pole positions. Finally, the nation that took the first season by storm has taken pole position for this one, courtesy of Loic Duval. Lining up alongside him on the front row of the grid for the standing start, Team Germany's Christian Vittoris. Then it's Switzerland, who desperately needs some points after seeing their gap eroded in the sprint race today. Canada well up there, matching their best ever qualifying position. New Zealand and Portugal next up, then South Africa and the Netherlands. Great Britain a bit farther up on this grid, ninth on the grid, up with the USA, who they clashed with earlier. Brazil and Australia follow next, then Ireland and Malaysia. Mexico and Italy, followed by Lebanon and China. Towards the back, India and the Czech Republic. And then the last row of the grid sees Pakistan and Team Indonesia. That's how they line up then in preparation for this race. Under 4 minutes to go to the start of the race. The Right Honourable Helen Clark, Prime Minister, will make the introduction.
Ladies and gentlemen, great to have the A1 GP back here in Taupo. We're a country with a great history in motorsports, and it's fantastic to see this here. And what great news that this A1 GP here in New Zealand is the first in the world to use a 30% biofuel mix for an international motor race. I want to wish all the competitors well for the feature race today.
Thank you, Prime Minister. Ladies and gentlemen, could I please ask you to be upstanding and observe a moment's silence for the passing of our great totara, Sir Edmund Hillary. Kia ora. Thank you very much. Ladies and gentlemen, could you please remain upstanding for the national anthem of Aotearoa, New Zealand. Hei-ho-a, hatua, honai-wi, matora, hata-whakarongo, na me. Defend our free land. God Pacific's triple star from the shafts of strife and war. Make her praises head afar. God defend New Zealand.
Gentlemen, for the pride of your nations, start your engines.
The call is given and the engines are firing up on the grid there. All prepared then for the feature race here at Taupo, and to see whether Johnny Rhee can do the double for the host nation. This time he's got a bit of a harder task ahead of him because he starts from fifth place on the grid rather than being on pole, as he was for the sprint race. It's France and Germany who will lead them away on the formation lap. Away they go. A little bit of a practice start for everybody here, John. And for those guys at the back of the grid, they've got to work out how to get around the corner too.
Well, I think the most important thing for those at the back of the grid is don't worry about it. It's a long way. 52 laps, 69 minutes, or plus one lap. And problem for Indonesia's car stalled at the back of the grid. He'll have to go pretty quickly to catch up to the tail of this field, because it's being led by Team France. Loic de Valle at a fairly good pace. Now he'll slow down once he gets up to turn 11 onto the main straight to draw the whole field back together. And we've now got that car running. So Satrio Hamanta for Indonesia sprints down the start finish straight, and he'll be catching up to the tail of the field pretty quickly.
Yeah, hopefully that'll give him a chance to get a bit more heat into his tyres, perhaps, than the other guys that will be starting around him. But that's a little scare he could have done without. Thankfully, Satrio Hamanta's on route. Switzerland still leading the points by 5 from New Zealand, with France close in there, 4 points behind. Then South Africa, Germany up to 5th now, 2 points ahead of Great Britain, and Great Britain losing out on a chance to score points earlier on. Netherlands and Ireland next up, then India and China. Both nations, though, far down on the grid. Brazil and Mexico also have scored reasonably well so far this year. Now, Canada have a big opportunity to move up from 13th. They start 4th on the grid. Portugal have a massive opportunity starting in 6th place as well.
Yeah, I think just that Portuguese car is slightly out of position in relation to the norm that we would expect to see in the top three rows. So keep an eye on João Urbano, because he's the one driver who's not been at this end of the grid as regularly as others around him, and he's the car that is on the inside going into turn one. We saw the contact that occurred there in the sprint race with the Swiss car, Malaysia and Canada. So João Urbano's got to keep himself aware that it isn't just going to be one in the first corner.
Neil Jani of Team Switzerland, he's had a disastrous start to the day. Can he pick it all up and recover and try and extend that championship lead? He's had wins already this year, of course, in Malaysia. Did the double there. He's had consistent finishes on the podium just about everywhere we have been. But France's Loic de Valle is still looking for his first win. He leads them through turn 12, the new revised corner there. Otherwise, this circuit remains the same as it was last year when he took those 2 second places behind Nico Hülkenberg of Germany. This time it's Christian Vitoris for the Germans, but he's looking very, very strong this weekend. And he was only a few thousandths of a second slower than Duval in qualifying.
Yeah, but he drove a very good race in the sprint race, and he actually got the advantage over Loic de Valle on the opening lap of the sprint race. And that was, you know, caught de Valle somewhat unawares out of turn 4 into turn 5. Opportunistic on the part of the young 18-year-old German driver, going to be 19th in April. So Loic de Valle just in pole position, best place to be, but fully aware that the challenge is going to come from Germany from his left.
Last few cars moving into position. Indonesia has managed to regain their spot on the grid. So here we go then, all set for 52 laps of the Taupo circuit in New Zealand. The 5-second board is given. The engine revs start to rise. Lights go out, away we go in Switzerland. What a start, but it might have been too quick. And Neil Jani takes the lead. Was it a jump start? We'll have to look at the replay.
Surely Switzerland was moving before anybody else did. But watch the melee of cars in turn one. But Switzerland leapt forward, split the French and German cars. And I don't know whether he just got the best start, anticipated it, or whether there was a jump start. That will be known to us very shortly. Robbie Kerr dives up the inside of Canada through turn 4. He picks up position. Everybody trying to get down the inside into turn 5. There's only room for one car at a time.
He's gone wide again, though, Kerr. He's lost the place back to Canada. Canada lost out big time there. They started fourth, but they lost 3 or 4 places on the start. It's bunched up behind. There's an accident. India on the inside. Oh, collision. India ends up spinning there.
Yeah, bodywork's flying, and the car's been spun round, and there was contact either with, I think, Australia. Bits of bodywork still coming off one of those cars. Contact clearly with Australia.
Oh, what a disappointment for Carter Gayen, who picked up that point of the sprint race. It's Switzerland that leads the race at the moment, being chased by France and then Germany. We wait to see. We've got yellow flags out. No sign of the safety car, though, on track at the moment. And Neil Jani, that blistering getaway. We will have to have another look at it, and I bet the race director's looking at it, but the safety car has been called, so yes, they will have to slow down.
Yeah, the marshals have just gotten to that car in turn 7. They're going to run quite a long way across the grass to get to that car. They're pushing the car now to safety. There we see the field bunched up as they come through turns 12, 13 and 14. But Switzerland, where did that start come from?
Well, it was electric. I mean, I was looking at the lights initially. I glanced back to look at the grid, and there was Switzerland already going between the two front row guys. But, well, we'll have to take a look in a minute. But there is the safety car on circuit. The Ferrari leads them round now, with Neil Jani just keeping a bit of tyre temperature by weaving around. Netherlands going well. They're in fourth. Portugal got away well. 5th. South Africa 6th. Canada dropped to 7th. Look at this, John.
Well, you can see him in. He's rolling, but I can't really see clearly whether the lights are out or not. Yeah, whatever it was, that's a legitimate start. It'll be the start of the series without question.
Absolutely.
I mean, just went between those two nations, and they were barely moving.
So take a look again, looking from the second.
I think he had to jump that. I mean, certainly looking at there, neither the front row cars moved, and already Neil was rolling. pointing his car between Germany and France. We'll wait to see.
Look at the bunching behind. Everybody was desperate to stay out of trouble after the incident in the sprint race. Malaysia got sandwiched again, and you can see Alex Hume backing out of being careful. He wants to make the end of this race.
And just keep an eye on Team GBR. They slid past Team Canada, but then that was returned at turn five.
So under safety car, there's poor Indian car, very damaged, weaving its way back towards the pit lane.
Yes, disappointment for India. You know, you think how your fortunes in motorsport can change. You on the top of the podium and 5 weeks ago back in China, and now you're the first car out of the feature race here in Taupo, New Zealand.
Yeah, bitterly disappointing, but no doubt India will be coming back and fighting hard later on in this series after that tremendous victory in China, as you say. But he's just about made it back to the pit lane.
Safety car leads the field down the main straight. I think the lights on the safety car have been turned out, so yep, the race will be underway in just a moment.
Absolutely. So it's going to be a quick intervention from the safety car, and then Neil Yarny's going to lead this group away. He slowed it right down. Now he floors the throttle, and into turn 12 he goes. Vitoris behind Duval. So it's Switzerland, followed by France, then Germany, and then watch out for the Netherlands in fourth position with Jeroen Bleekemolen trying to defend that place from Portugal. And then also watch out for Great Britain's Robbie Kerr, because he's going to be fighting to move up the order. Here comes Ireland as well. Ireland in a big, big challenge down to turn one. Bit of a lock-up, manages to save it, but under pressure from New Zealand.
And how did New Zealand get that far back? They've got Ireland ahead of them, so difficult start for Johnny Reid. He did start back in that race. Well,
he started fifth.
How did he get all the way back?
Yeah, we hadn't spotted he dropped that many places. Way, way down for Johnny Reid, so he really got caught out on that first lap. I tell you what, if he gets a good result out of this one, it's going to be a huge drive. But up front, it's still Switzerland versus France, then Germany, Netherlands, Portugal, South Africa, Canada, Great Britain, then USA, Brazil, Ireland, and New Zealand, then all the way back down in 12th position ahead of Malaysia, Mexico, Italy, Lebanon, followed by China and Pakistan.
And France is all over the back with Switzerland as they come through turn 10, trying to get side by side. Oh, slides the car, dirt tracks the car, almost gets under the rear wing of the Swiss car, has to back out of the throttle. That's going to give the run to Germany. They have been on the throttle earlier and harder, so Christian Vitoris has got a chance to pick up. Is he going to use power boost? Switzerland is certainly on it. Further on the field, no one really is still using any at all.
That's surprising. Here, I thought Germany would have gone for it. Look at Canada trying to get down the inside of South Africa. Has he done it? Yes, he has. Great move by Rob Wickens.
Well, I tell you what, talking about a missile being launched. Well, that was a move from young Rob Wickens to get down the inside. Christian, or Adrian Zaug, never the easiest to pass, but he had no choice. The place was going to be taken away from him.
Zaug has been struggling on the brakes all weekend. I don't think he has much confidence, and I think Wickens can cleverly use that to his advantage. Look at this. Lebanon has hit the back of Italy. Round both Italy and Lebanon go, and that could be the end of their races.
And somewhere along the line, where is Team Ireland?
Have they dropped back as well? Yeah, they have. You're absolutely right. Ireland has dropped right back, so whatever's happened to them. But this, now look, drive-through penalty. Switzerland, John, have been done for a jump start.
I'm not surprised. That certainly looked to be a jump start to me. We've now got two cars in turn one. One in the gravel between the racetrack and the barrier, and the other on the edge of the racetrack. So once again, safety, I'm sure, will be, because that car will take a moment or two. There's no marshal available to get to the Italian car. You see it just by the side of the track. Still Switzerland leading this race as they come up through turn 11, and this is on lap 4.
Safety car's out there, so he won't presumably be allowed to make his drive-through penalty while safety car is out there. He'll probably have to wait until safety car comes in. Safety car taking that route onto the track. And of course, there's Chris Alajajian. I feel so sorry for him in a way, although that one might have been his mistake. Earlier on today, he was in a points-paying position. It looked like Lebanon might score their first ever point, and he got hit by Thomas Enger. Let's take a look. This was something else.
Might be you where Ireland, because we lost our last incident,
the first lap,
yes. And that was just Noreen Carthacain, way, way too ambitious, trying to slide down the inside. Really, very little chance of getting down the inside into turn 7. There's not enough room. And particularly in the opening lap, when everybody's so compacted, then you're really trying to make space where there isn't.
And Australia took a big whack from that, didn't they? Still running, though, John Martin. He's down in 17th place, but I wouldn't be surprised if there isn't a fair bit of damage on the side of that car. He has done his drive-through.
He's back on track. That's
helped, because
yes,
he's done it
indeed.
Under safety car.
Yeah, so. And I think the Swiss team very happy indeed with that. They're looking back and thinking, well, we got the penalty, but are we going to be penalised that heavily or not? Not as heavily had they done it under running outside of the safety car.
But I tell you what, this does change the perspective for the championship. Let's take a look. This is Lebanon hitting Italy.
Yeah, I mean, again, a no-brainer, trying to get down the inside, nowhere near far enough up alongside the Italian car. And there's the incident. Contact into turn one. We've seen a lot of problems. And, well, again, that rear, left rear, whether that was the consequence of riding up the back of the Italian car, I suspect it was. Well, Team GB on the garage.
What happened there? I wonder what happened there then. Of course, Ireland had a problem around that same time. Do you think there was any kind of incident between them?
Well, Ireland was involved with the battle with New Zealand. That was a battle of currently New Zealand in ninth place. We didn't see Ireland for a minute, then it's back on racetrack.
Well, I think Simon Hill's got news from the pit lane for us. Simon, what can you tell us?
Yeah, Robbie Kerr from the outset said the car didn't feel right. Obviously had that problem in the sprint race, and then radioed in that it looked like from the dash there was a problem with the engine. The guys are frantically checking. The engineers from Zytec are looking, and there's a very, very strong smell of oil here. So looks like it could be game over for Robbie Kerr.
Oh, what a weekend. What a weekend for Team GBR. It's been disastrous for them. The safety car remains out there. The lights are still flashing away. They're not going to be going racing just yet, but France are now leading this race because Switzerland have done the drive-through penalty. So it's now France 1, Germany 2, Netherlands 3rd, Portugal up to 4th place. What a position that is in prospect for João Urbano. And Robbie Kerr's out of it. As Simon mentioned, it looks as though it's all over. Now let's take another look at the start of this race, John. We'll try and keep an eye on the lights as well. And that getaway that Neil Yarny made, and he's been penalised for it. Watch the lights.
Okay, there, lights on top left screen. Look to the second car on the right.
Well, I don't know.
Well, the lights have gone out, but there was no movement from the cars ahead.
I don't know. Looking at that, you have to say, well, actually, the car from that angle only seemed to move once the lights went out. But, of course, that angle is a bit deceptive. The camera's a long way from the car, and it might have been he was just creeping forward.
He certainly did have that initial movement before he really nailed the throttle and stopped between the two cars. But judging by that particular view, you have to say, let's look at it again. Red lights, wait for them to go out. See any movement with the car?
Well, no, actually, looking at
it looks like the front row of the grid didn't move at all.
And look, those guys have just been watching the same picture you have. They've been studying
Absolutely.
The monitor. They can't believe it, that well, they've been done for it.
Based on those pictures, you have to say that Switzerland's been hard done by.
Well, he's got them work to do now because this changes the whole championship now. Switzerland, who came to New Zealand with a very healthy advantage, looked very much in control of the whole situation. Suddenly, they are presumably going to lose the title lead, depending on what happens up front, but they've got one of their big challengers, France, leading the race now. New Zealand, of course, not going so well because they didn't have a good first lap, although with the odd few cars that have just dropped out, they have gained a bit. They're up to eighth because of several other cars having problems, and Johnny Reid is back in the points here.
Trying to solve the problem about Ireland, we didn't know what happened to Ireland. All I can imagine is that with Ireland running 18th and effectively last, and USA 17th, one pace ahead, USA started in 10th place, Ireland started in 13th, and all I can assume is that somewhere down the line, those two cars must have come into contact. They must have had to make a pit stop when all this other melee was going on around the circuit.
Right, ready to go racing once again, and France is the pace setter. Germany going to try and make it a big challenge into this little sequence of corners, but Loic Duval gets on it very, very quickly. Third place, Netherlands under a bit of pressure from Portugal, although João Urbano now under pressure from Canada, in fact, for fourth place. This could be interesting down towards turn one. No change between the top two. France lead from Germany, and everybody else slotting into position pretty much. I don't think anybody's gone for the big move this time.
No, I think the lessons have been learned. Everybody much better behaved, and the realisation is that 46 laps to go is a very long way in this race, and a number of drivers have been impatient, thrown it away unnecessarily. And the opportunity here is this is a race where it is possible for the drivers of the nations that are not necessarily those that are likely to win, but to pick up the points for 7th, 8th, 9th and 10th.
Six laps have been completed. We're only two laps away from the first pit stop window opening up. So that's going to make life interesting as well. And Johnny Reid for New Zealand, now he finds himself in 8th place despite that fairly disastrous opening lap where presumably he was getting out of the way of cars that were involved in incidents. Look at that, it's a great shot. Oh, Ireland sideways through turn 9.
You can see the Ireland car, it ratchets its way round turn 9. More aggressive than other cars we've seen. France has always been particularly good through turn 9. The car rides those bumps better pretty much than anybody else out there.
So up front, still no problem for France. But look how Germany's staying with France. I think Duval expected to be able to ease away, and he's not doing it. He's not getting away from Germany, who's been so quick. Christian Vitoris, the youngster, going well. And now look at Johnny Reid of New Zealand putting the pressure on Brazil's Sergio Jimenez.
Yeah, I mean, a lot of pressure coming. Oh, the Brazil car gets wide on the exit of turn 14. Going to give New Zealand a chance to slot down the inside. Oof. They just sweep across the by of the New Zealand car. But that was pressure. Now he runs wide in the exit of two. But Johnny Reid, New Zealand, can't get that job done.
Well, Jimenez was certainly pretty violent in his attempt to chop across in front of New Zealand, but it was just about fair enough, but he's got to be careful, he's got to behave himself, and Black Beauty right behind there, trying to pick up another place after the victory earlier today. Johnny Reid's fired up to try and do the double, but from here it's going to be tough to do that. Behind us, a bit of a lock up there from Mexico and Pakistan, nearly ran into the back of them. Mexico running in 10th place at the moment, I believe, just ahead of Pakistan.
They were headshot looking out of 8 into turn 9, the bumps on the middle of the corner, run wide in the exit, you catch the curb into the dust. So New Zealand once again beginning the process, trying to run down the car just ahead. That's the Brazil car, looks up the inside, gets the job done.
Wow.
Sweeps round the apex of the corner and takes the advantage away from Brazil. New Zealand up to 7th, Brazil down to 8.
Great move from Johnny Reid. It is possible to overtake when you're determined and committed, and that was a good move from Johnny Reid. Right, that's one more down. He's got to keep attacking here in the early stages of this race, and with pit stops coming up soon as well. You're on board with Brazil, just been passed by New Zealand, and now Malaysia are the one tucking into the mirrors of the Brazilian car, not quite close enough. Then it's Mexico running very well in the hands of David Garza, and there you are, as a replay of how New Zealand managed it.
I'm an absolute textbook overtake, prompted by an error from Brazil, just too wide in the middle of turn 11, allows the New Zealand car to get through. You can see that the New Zealand car hugged the whole way around the corner and put himself in.
Malaysia's had a spin at turn one. Alex Jung rejoins, having lost a lot of time. And, he's right at the back again, would you believe it? Malaysia's luck doesn't get any better. Don't know what happened, whether there was a mistake or not. But New Zealand are on a bit of a charge here. Now they've got to go chasing after South Africa. And as we've seen today already, South Africa's struggling a little bit on the brakes. That'll give Johnny the confidence to go chasing after him. France lead the race, though, and the pit stops are being prepared, John. Their French team's out in the pit lane. They're getting ready to receive Loic Duval.
This is coming up. We're on the 8th lap, so when he comes into the pit lane area, he will be allowed to make that pit stop. So France, the first, I don't know if they're the only, but certainly the first taking advantage. I'm not quite sure why they needed to do that. They've got control of the race. There was no necessity for them to make that pit stop quite so early, but he's in, and this is Germany.
Yeah, this is going to be the battle between the teams then in the pit lane. France into the pit lane, Germany right behind. So it's now down to the two crews to see which of these emerges first and which will be the first car after the first round of pit stops.
You have to believe this was the strategy placed on either team. If they were leading the other, just shadow it, come into the pit. France much further on the pit lane. Germany on the car up the jacks, wheels on. Same for France.
And Germany's on the way. Germany's underway already. France is still finishing off their pit stop. Are they going to get out in front? I think Germany's going to take the advantage. France has a problem. And Germany...
Oh, the Czech car just goes across the nose of the French car. So a further penalty for France. Unintentional, but that's what happens. They're slower pit stop. Now, we heard Loic Duval say, we don't need to make record-breaking pit stops. Well, that one was maybe one of the poorer ones we've seen from France. A problem for Australia getting that car back. Look at the side of the bodywork. That was the consequence of the attack on Team Australia by India in the opening lap. They're minus, but 2 square feet of bodywork on the left-hand side. Here's what happens. This is the French car's about to go. Czech car pulls across the front. And that's that lack of cooperation between the two teams. And that could have been the end of both teams had Loic Duval not had the presence of mind to get out of it and break.
Yeah, good awareness by Duval, wasn't it, to sort that out. The Dutch car leads this race. The Netherlands into the pits, though, he comes now. So he leads it only for one lap, followed by Portugal, Canada and South Africa. So all the other group that were running in the top six are now making their pit stops.
And it's significant that New Zealand didn't come in. They've gone one more lap. They were running behind South Africa. So now Johnny Reid has got a lot of clear air. He's got the best part of, well, certainly a third of the racetrack to get the hammer down. He's got to come in between laps 8 and 16, but watch for stunning lap times from New Zealand. Johnny Reid, this is the opportunity that he needs to take advantage of the fact that all the difficulties that he had in the opening lap, he can now overcome.
The Dutch car retains its advantage over these others, although Canada, they're now ahead of Portugal. Portugal's lost a place. South Africa rejoins pretty much where it was. 32 seconds for Canada. That's one of the quickest stops there. That almost matches the time that Germany did. They had a brilliant stop. Brazil have had a fantastic stop as well.
Yes, just a tenth of a second in it and a little bit of a lock-up for Christian Vitoros and Team Germany.
What a stop that was by their guys.
Well, they did a... Well, that's what was a normal pit stop should be, down into turn 7. Gets the car into the corner.
So New Zealand now leads the race ahead of Mexico, Pakistan and Indonesia, and then Switzerland and the United States. None of those guys have made their first pit stop yet. They still have a number of laps in which they're allowed to do that. So New Zealand currently the race leader, but of those cars that have stopped, there's no doubt that it's Germany. Oh, and Australia being pushed back into the pit garage. Looks as though it's all over for the nation that will be hosting the next round of A1GP.
Well, Johnny Reid's lap, that last lap a little bit slower, 1 minute 18.1. Now, I don't know where he lost all that time, because he had clear air for the first time since the start of the feature race. Fastest lap still to France, 1 minute 16.7. Pretty much everybody running in the 1 minute 17.6s, so the best of the rubber clearly has gone, and it will be now an eye, keep an eye on those that have made that pit stop, Germany in particular, France and others, to see what their lap, 15.897, Germany now, fastest lap on fresh rubber.
I'm just looking at the Switzerland in the pits, look at USA, they have been shown as having made a pit stop, John, they are ahead of Germany, is that possible? How does that work?
I don't know. I can't work it out at all. And let's wait and see when the whole thing cycles itself through. Sometimes it takes a lap beyond where we are watching from. So Brazil and Portugal currently under investigation by the race stewards.
Well, we'll have to keep an eye on that. But Team USA being shown as having made a pit stop. We didn't see the pit stop itself. Whether he had an earlier problem and had to do a little drive
through. Well, he did, I think, because he was running. Remember, I think he and Ireland might have gotten together.
Right. Okay.
And somewhere down the line, I think that was maybe where the pit stop came from. Currently, we're waiting to see what New Zealand's going to do. It's going to be very soon before they come across. He's in the pits. Well, maybe they've decided the lap time isn't there in this set of tyres. We've seen the pace of Germany on a fresh set of rubber. So bring Reid in, bring New Zealand team in, get new tyres on, give him an opportunity to get himself back up. Maybe a mirror of what we could expect from the sprint race.
Another crucial stop coming up for the crews here. Mexico also in around the same time, so are Pakistan and Indonesia. New Zealand away. Let's see what the total time is, but we'll only see when the clock stops at the end of the pit lane. He's about halfway down the pit lane, so it seems like an age at that 60 kilometre per hour speed limit all the way down. Wait till he gets to the line. What's the time going to be? It's not quite as quick as Germany's, but not far off. 33 and a half seconds. One of the quicker, but not the quickest stop.
And he gets in just ahead of Brazil as Brazil goes into turn one. So Johnny Reid got one car that he had to pass on the racetrack behind him. He's now facing again the South Africa car. It is South Africa car directly ahead of him with Portugal, Canada, and then Netherlands.
So at the moment, the United States leading this race, but we think they're going to have to make their pit stop. We think they had a pit stop earlier, but that was for damage. So there's Jonathan Summerton absolutely flying. He is going quickly. He's doing quick lap times at the moment, is Jonathan Summerton, but not quite as quick as some of the guys who stopped. And at the moment, it looks like the likes of Germany and France are still setting the outright pace.
Well, America are staying out. They've chosen to do so. The difficulty is that while he's got clear air, and that's ideal for a driver to get on and do the job, he's done a 1:16.8. But remember that the new set of tyres is going to give you probably the best part of a second for up to about 2 to 3 laps before once again everything settles down. But they're taking advantage of it. He's on lap, we're on lap 34, going to 14. So he's going to be coming in within this lap or the next lap.
John Martin in the pits for Australia. I think that's the result of the damage between him and India at the beginning of the race. Netherlands ahead of Canada. They're running fourth and fifth. Sixth, Portugal. Seventh there is South Africa. It could become sixth when the United States make their stop. So South Africa are in the top 10 clearly, and useful chance of scoring points. No mistakes so far from João Urbano of Portugal. He knows he needs a good, solid event this time, and so far, so good from him.
Well, that certainly was a good start, but I was concerned that his slightly out of position, grid position, he might get overexcited and be over rash. But he's done a sound, strong job, and he's keeping that car in contact with South Africa behind and Canada just ahead.
A couple of cars further back that are interesting to watch. The Swiss and Irish cars are tucked in behind Pakistan at the moment. Both are very quick cars. Both have had problems, of course. Pakistan's running in 11th place, but Adam is always one of the most difficult guys to get past. He'll fight for every inch, and it's going to be up to Neil Yarny and Adam Carroll to fight a way through.
It certainly will be, and we know that Adam Khan in that Pakistan car, very, very late on the brakes, able to brake as late as anybody and takes away any opportunity or advantage. Not necessarily quick in the corner, and that then slows down the momentum of those behind. And that seesaw effect, which is so frustrating for the quicker car, it's up to you to make your best of what you got.
Just heard that they've looked at that jump start again, and what we couldn't see from that long shot was the wheels were definitely spinning before the lights went out. So they've rechecked that. Our long shot on the camera, I did say you had to be a bit careful looking at it, and from the other angle as well, they could see the wheels were spinning. So Swiss were done fairly, and there is Switzerland tucked in behind Pakistan with Ireland just behind.
This is the last thing that either Switzerland or Ireland would want, because they know that they've got a car and they're capable of driving quicker than Adam Khan in the Pakistan car. But this is all legitimate. Pakistan in 11th place on merit. They've not made mistakes. They've not jumped the start. They're there, and they're not going to give it up.
Absolutely right, and it's going to be tough for these guys to get through. Riding on board with Adam Carroll of Team Ireland. And Pakistan a little wide on that corner. That might give Neil Yani. No, doesn't quite give him a chance to nip through. There is Yani in the white, blue and red Swiss car. The car that has been so strong all season, but what a horrible weekend he's having here.
Well, he's got to be very careful because he'd get too close to the rear of the Pakistan car. Adam Khan keeps the car to the left of the track, defends the entry into turn 11. Not able to do Switzerland what we saw earlier. Getting under the wing of the Brazil car, and that was of course Johnny Reid for New Zealand.
Yes, indeed, and he's got to try his hardest, Pakistan.
Oh, he's moving, be careful, he doesn't start going from one side to the other. He's committed himself to stay on the left-hand side, side by side in turn 12.
Oh, and he's had to go across the grass.
Watch, Adam Carroll takes that position away. Damaged wing, Switzerland's wing, I think, has been damaged as he went over the grass on the inside of the corner.
It just gets worse for Switzerland, yet the front wing is jammed under his car. And that's his front.
And a big lock-up, and Adam Carroll gets it wrong. Adam Carroll, the beneficiary, and in the space of two corners, two cars have got into the problem.
Oh, he's rejoined right in front of everybody. Adam, what are you doing?
Well, he just drove across the racetrack. He doesn't care that Canada's coming through. That's Canada's problem. But there's Switzerland, the wing, absolutely. And now he can barely steer the car because that front wing is jamming under the right front wheel and it's shredding that right front tire.
Well, he had to go for it. He couldn't afford to be stuck behind Pakistan for long. He went for the move around the outside, but they ran out of space. He went across the grass. There goes the wing at last. At least he's unjammed. But let's take a look at this again, John.
Well, side by side, but of course there's no space for two cars. And all he could do and what he should have done is lift off. Once he found himself in that position, it was absolutely, he was on the wrong part of the track at the wrong time. And Adam Khan, fully entitled, he was ahead, half a car's length ahead, and there was the contact that ended the race for Switzerland.
Pakistan may well have had a punctured tyre out of that. That could have caused him to go off at the next corner, actually, because it was the wing end plate that hit the back of the Pakistan car. What was the reaction from Max Velti? A little shake of the head, that was all it was.
I mean, can it get bad? No, it's only gotten worse for Switzerland.
It's unbelievable. USA have now made their stop, as we thought they had been in earlier, with a problem. So that was now their official stop that's been made.
And once again, these two countries, America and Ireland, find themselves back on the racetrack, running nose to tail. Adam Carroll got the momentum. He wants to find a way past the USA as quickly as possible. And as each corner passes, it's going to become more difficult once Jonathan gets the feel of this new set of tyres, gets the speed back up to where it's been. It's still fine. Adam Carroll will put pressure as Switzerland comes in, and there the nose. They're going to take it off. There's still a long way to go. 36 laps of this race, a physically tough race, and a long race in terms of lap time.
Yeah, it's worth sending him back out. It's always the fastest lap to go for, the point for that. But it's being a bit of a nightmare for them. First time that Neil Yani's been to Taupo. He didn't race for Swiss team last year. It was Sebastian Buemi. Race leader, meanwhile, just crosses the line on the other side of that pit wall. It's Germany leading from France, so he's a lap down now. He is a lap behind the race leaders on the speed limiter to the end of the pit lane. And now Neil Yani rejoins. So he's been lapped also by the Netherlands running third and Canada running fourth. And I tell you what, that's a good little battle between Netherlands and Canada for third position at the moment. We'll keep an eye on it. Here's what happened to Pakistan. He may already have picked up a puncture, I don't know.
It's difficult to tell because it would have been the right rear tire that was punctured. So I think it was just too late on the brakes.
Yeah.
Hard to tell from that picture, just not getting a clear enough view of it. But all to the benefit of Ireland, they get through relatively trouble-free. In the meantime, back to Germany, leading now by 1.1 seconds from France and second and Netherlands, a further 4.6 seconds behind France.
So let's quickly run you through the order with all the first stops having been made. It's Germany leading. There you are. France in second place. Then quite a gap back to the Netherlands in third. Canada in a fighting fourth. Then Portugal in fifth. South Africa sixth. New Zealand in seventh place. Then it's Brazil in a strong eighth. China have come up to ninth. That's good effort from China because they were back in 18th place on the grid. They've picked up places that others have had problems. The USA now in 10th. So having stayed out there, they got out in front of Ireland. That's crucial for Jonathan Summerton. Now in 10th. Ireland 11th. Mexico 12th. Then it's the Czech Republic, Indonesia, Pakistan and Malaysia. Those guys all still running. Switzerland now right at the back in 17th place. A lap down on the leaders. And then I think the others all out. Australia, Great Britain, Italy, Lebanon and India all out of this race. Well, still a long way to go in the race, but Germany so far looking strong. Christian Vitoris, but he cannot escape the clutches of Team France's Loic Duval. And we could be on for a new winner here today, John. Neither of these guys have ever won a race in A1GP.
No, in part it's going to come down to stamina. In part it's going to come down to how well the setup of both these cars are, and basically both of them are pretty much as good as you can get. The suspicion is that Loic Duval has got the slightly better car of the two over the bumps, and that's through turn nine, and that's where it's noticeable. All that impact on driver's fitness and driver's stamina, and I would imagine Loic Duval, he's a more experienced driver, he's driven longer races than Christian Vettori. In that respect, it might favour him. The fact is, he's got to find a way past Germany to take the lead of the race.
We're on board with Team Canada's Rob Wickens there, and he's driving a beautiful race at the moment, sitting there in fourth position. He's got to see if he can just keep the pressure on Jeroen Bleeker-Mollen, who's a very solid driver himself. But remember, Rob Wickens, only 18-year-old from Toronto, burst onto this A1GP scene with a podium finish in his first race in Malaysia after he qualified in fifth. It really was a stunning debut. He's been pretty strong in the few races that he's done already, but he's got another great chance here today of maybe scoring another podium finish for Team Canada. Meanwhile, South Africa has been caught by New Zealand. This is the race for sixth place. Johnny Reid in a car that's working beautifully, but he's lost out a bit in the early stages of this race. Now he's closed up to South Africa, and now he's got to see if he can work out a way of getting past him.
Well, never the easiest car again to pass in the circuit. Adrian Zarg, very accustomed to being able to defend his position, not always having the fastest car, but knowing how to use that car effectively. But that battle is closing down. It's now into just over half a second, so Christian Vettori is coming under more pressure. Coming up to turn 11, the line into the corner. France holds a slightly tighter line in the middle, then Germany's able to get back. So probably quicker for France entering the corner. Germany maybe marginally quicker off the corner.
Great lap that from Duval last time around. A 116.5 as opposed to a 116.9 from Vettori. Whether he made a tiny little lock-up somewhere, I don't know, but it definitely allowed Frenchman to close up. Yes, and as you say, John, he's applying pressure, isn't he?
Yes, he is. Christian Vettori leading this race on merit, running strongly in the lead. But he's seen the lead evaporate, a further tenth of a second shaved off that advantage by Loic Duval for France. But behind them, Netherlands pretty much keeping station, running very much a similar sort of pace in third place, and Canada just half a second behind the Netherlands for fourth.
Yeah, this is the battle between Netherlands and Canada. Rob Wickens, he's tight, able to get pretty close to the back of the Dutch car, but as yet not close enough to put in any kind of challenge. Just a little bit further back, just looking down the order. I noticed that Indonesia just went past the Czech Republic in a private little battle that's going on for 13th. But this is the interesting one for third place.
Just keep an eye on the hands of Rob Wickens. You can see how much feedback's coming through the steering wheel. He's also got a taped-up steering wheel just to give him that slightly thicker grip on that wheel. Just take it a little bit easier through here. Turn nine, look at the work that goes on. That's a lot of physical work, and the bumps, they're vertical impacts. Now, again, France right on the gearbox of Germany coming out of turn 11.
Yeah, that's where he really applies the pressure. He says, look how close I can get to you here. And a driver loves to be in that situation. It's fascinating seesaw battle between these two. In the first stint, France led. He's beginning to just move around. That wasn't an attempt to overtake it. It was an attempt to unsettle Vettori.
Yeah, and also you could see Vettori just pulling slightly more to the middle of the road before he got to the corner, just sending out a message, I'm not going to give you the opportunity. But of course, that signals to me that, in fact, Germany are responding to the pressure that France is applying.
Indeed, and that's what it's all about. Just keep the pressure on. So Rob Creswell there, race engineer for Christian Vettori, man who took Nico Hülkenberg to the title, Germany to the title in last year's series. Germany took two wins here at Taupo last year. They would love to take another victory. Michael Amermuller won for them in China last time out, and now they've got another real hot shot on their hands. He was impressive when he made his debut last year, but didn't race quite so well initially. Now he's proving that he can race hard.
Something for our viewers at home to keep an eye on, particularly coming out of that turn seven. Watch the position of the head of the Germany car and of the France car, because I suspect as this race progresses, we've got some 22 laps now into the race, because that would be an indication if fatigue is setting in for either of these two drivers. They're pushing to the limit of their natural ability. They're 1 minute 16.8 for Germany, 16.7 for France, gap 0.472 of a second. So the pressure constant to Germany.
Yeah, and you'd have to say that Duval would be favoured there, John. He's done a lot of A1GP races.
For Indonesia.
Well, just after he'd managed to get past the Czech Republic as well, and now he's lost it. But, yeah.
Well, in fact, there's three cars involved. Czech Republic and Malaysia and Indonesia.
Yeah, absolutely. Don't quite know what went on there, but he's well off in the scoria, that's called it, rather than gravel. It is actually a volcanic material that they use as the gravel trap here in New Zealand. And it slowed him down pretty effectively. And
Australia's gone off in the same corner.
I didn't even know he was back out, to be honest, because he was in the pits for a long time.
One wonders, is there something down there in the circuit that we're not aware of? Because three cars four cars now in one corner, and again Marshall's running wave flags before you get down to turn seven, so you're required again. One of those cars, I can't think of, was France actually. Oh, again, watch it, look at this. Netherlands, there is something on the racetrack down there, because the Germany and France going through the corner got into big time trouble. And now cars, I think that might well be Canada coming back onto the track as well.
I think the Australian car's blown its engine and he's deposited a load of oil down there.
Something down there, I think you're right, it is either water and or oil, because people that have followed through have been absolutely caught unawares.
My goodness, the leaders did well to get through there, because I'm just looking how slow New Zealand went through there. Safety car is on track. Oh, it's all happening here, isn't it?
We've only got a waved yellow flag. We need to see a banded yellow and red flag indicating something on the track.
And I tell you what, Canada has, I think, got ahead of the Netherlands in all this. I'm just looking now. Well, I don't know where the Netherlands is. I think they may have got caught out on that oil. Canada's third now, John. Canada's there in third place.
Oh, catch your breath. I mean,
there's Portugal now in fourth. And Netherlands, he must have got caught up on the oil. He's dropped
down. He was one of the cars that did get caught up here. Yeah. Let's look and see. Tatru Amanta, that's the car that seemingly started the whole issue. Spins in the middle of the track now. Does somebody clip it and damage a radiator? He's off. He's all right. Malaysia's gone through. He comes. No, he doesn't come back onto the racetrack quite yet. He's all on his own. But somewhere down there, we saw incident. There's the consequence. That was a little bit later. There's the oil. That was the spin that we saw from the Netherlands. And the car then just blinded by the dust.
My goodness. Just get a bit offline and even nowhere. And there's certainly something down, as you said, on that track. And opportunities here for others to take advantage. And that's what Canada has certainly done. But Australia, I'm afraid it's all over. Oh, he's been told to get back in the car, I think.
Well, he's getting back in the car. But who put the fluid down?
Yeah, that's the question. I'm not sure it was him, actually, because they were already spinning.
They were spinning here
before he got there.
We saw three cars. There was Indonesia, Malaysia and another car, and then the Australia car came round.
Yeah.
And then it all went absolutely ballistic.
So where did the fluid or whatever it is come from? That is still the
because
big question.
Germany and France were almost equally caught out in that particular moment down in turn seven.
Let's get some news from the pit lane. Simon has news on Australia. Simon.
I just had a chat with the guys on the Australia pit with Rob Arnott and the rest of the guys. Apparently, it was an oil and it certainly didn't come from the Australian car. Basically, John Martin rode in and said he came through the corner immediately after those guys had spun, and he said it was just like being on the beach. There was just sand and muck everywhere. So that's what called him out.
Right, okay, well, that makes sense. I suppose if there was that much dust around, we know how slippery the track got yesterday when the dust was being blown around by the wind. Maybe it was that simple.
Well, I mean, certainly if that was what it was, we couldn't see that the track looked that dirty. But the dust is so fine. It's like it is volcanic ash and effect of thunderstone. And it's like powder. It is so, so fine. But if it's on the track, as a fine layer on the track, and you're the first, second car down, well, you've lost contact with the racetrack. You're just simply driving on that very, very fine powder.
So, what's happening? We've got the safety car out. There's Australia rejoining with that little bit of bodywork still dangling away on the left-hand side. That was still a result of the earlier incident with India. Czech Republic's come in again. I wonder if they're going to be able to send him on his way. He's been really struggling. Car doesn't look as though it's handling particularly well. Puncture by the look of it, because they're just changing the one wheel. So he's picked up a left rear puncture and he's going to go back on his way again. He's pretty much towards the back of the field, but he ain't going to give up. So it's Germany that currently leads this race behind the safety car. France, of course, were harrying them all the way until the safety car came out. There was no gap between them, really, and there's little between them now. Then it's Canada, third. We've got the Swiss car up there on the road, but that's because he's been lapped. So don't worry about the Swiss car in terms of position. We're looking at top speeds on your graph at the moment, so that's not the race positions, that's top speeds. And actually Ireland have the highest top speed in this race so far, as Indonesia's car gets pushed away. What happened when Australia got pushed started here? Was there a little bit of a problem?
I suspect there's a load of gravel somewhere in the bottom of the car. And there they go. There you can see the stuff being... Look at it. Now he's just put down much of the stuff that he actually found when he came down to that corner in the first place. So fortunately, everybody running behind the safety car. We're waiting to see when the safety car light is going to be put out. We've got a clear track down at turn seven.
Now, I don't know quite why...
Lights are still on the safety car.
Switzerland has moved to the head of the queue, which I don't quite understand. I know he's been lapped and all that, but I don't quite understand why he's gone to the head of the queue. Normally, he would sort of hold
your
position.
Now, has he been waved through?
He may have been, yeah. He's been waved now, yeah. He's been waved past the safety car. That's interesting.
So no, he's not. He's going to stay out. So he's been waved through, and he's now got the opportunity to run on his own and do the best he can to catch up to the tail of this crocodile of cars. And safety car continues one more lap. Three safety car interventions so far in this race, and we're only on lap 20, going on to lap 25.
New Zealand there moving around. New Zealand currently running in seventh place. Still a great shot at scoring useful points. And with big rival Switzerland in so much trouble in this race, they can still perhaps grab the series lead. But that could go to France with the way that France are going here today.
But, you know, all these safety car interventions have been a real blessing in disguise for most of the field. If they had a 52 race, a lap race without any intervention, just the pit stops for pits for wheels and tyres. As Australia comes in, are they going to go back out again? But it's giving all these drivers the opportunity to catch their breath, to recover, and once the safety car goes back in, then they were going to be at least capable of pushing hard for another series of laps.
Indeed, yes, it does give them a bit of a break. There we are, watching them through the infield section. Brazil still in there. China up to ninth now as a result of all the problems for other people. So Frankie Cheng is keeping his head when others are losing theirs. And he's up into ninth place, back into the points again. That'll please the Chinese team after that fantastic third place they achieved in the first of the two races at Zhuhai a few weeks ago. But up front, there's no doubt there's going to be a tremendous battle between these two, Germany and France. There's been little to choose between them so far in terms of outright pace. And it's going to be a real battle to the end, I think, to see which one of them comes through to take their first win. Of course, let's not forget that now Canada have had the chance to close up, and Rob Wickens might join in the fun and games himself.
Well, lights are still flashing on the safety car, and to me, the racetrack appears to be, you know, ready to go motor racing on. Still got Neil Yarny, he's about a third of the way round. The racetrack's trying to catch up to the tail of this group of cars. Safety car remains on track for one more lap.
Indeed, so it's taking a little bit of time to get everything sorted out.
I don't honestly understand why, because the Indonesia car is way, way in the infield. It's a totally safe place. The track appears to be clear. There's no reason why the safety car couldn't have been brought back in at the end of the last lap. That was lap 25, but obviously there's things going on that we don't know about. Maybe they want to get all the marshals that were involved in the removal of these cars back to their designated stations.
The graphic you're looking at shows how many power boosts are still available to the nations, and there's still quite a few for most, actually. They have up to eight to use in this feature race, and a number of nations still have quite a few power boosts available to them. Each time they use that, it's an extra 30 brake horsepower. Very useful down the long straight here at Taupo. But they're saving it up, obviously. And I was just looking at the point situation. If they were to finish pretty much where they are now, then France would take the lead in the series. But New Zealand can do something about that. If Jonny Reid can pick off a few more places here before the end of the race, then it could be that France and New Zealand will be virtually tied together, with Switzerland close behind. Right up, we'd have a three-way battle going on to the next stage of the championship.
Well, we're exactly at half distance of this 52-lap race. There's been packs of incidents throughout it, and we've still got a long way to go. And we've lost the best part of six cars out of this 22-car field. So there's a lot more space on the racetrack. Not to say it's not going to be a further incident, but keep an eye on that battle going on between South Africa and sixth, New Zealand and seventh. That's going to be the focal point. The lights are out on the safety car.
Ready to go racing. Once again, it's Germany, France and Canada. Canada's going to have to get on with it here, get a bit closer to keep them under pressure. They all bunch up. Ooh, careful, boys. They've all bunched up too much. Ooh.
Well, Germany slowed them down, deliberately slowed them down, then accelerates, trying to catch everybody on the brake while he's on the throttle. I think Loic Duval and Rob Wickens were up for that one.
Yes, indeed, but everybody else behind got a little caught out. Meanwhile, Switzerland, of course, have been waved through, so they're back on the lead lap. Germany with France right behind, and you can just see there the Netherlands maybe trying to make a move, but everyone, I think, is just going to settle into position here and try and look for any advantage. Germany from France. You're on board third place, Canada. Rob Wickens, the 18-year-old, keeping a close eye on them. Then Jean Wabano of Portugal and the Netherlands of Jeroen Bleekemolen. USA and Ireland still very close together on track, of course, and they're battling for what is effectively the final point.
New Zealand trying to get really close through turn five, running down the back of the South Africa car into turn seven. That was the bogey corner that caught everybody unawares. But up front, it's France now right under the rear wing going into turn nine, trying to get a run up into turn 11 under brakes. We saw some of them were taking there in the sprint race.
Very quick here is Loic Duval up into this top corner. corner that leads onto the longest straight. Look at him under braking. He's so fast.
Runs wide.
Could be a chance for Canada, but he doesn't run that wide. He keeps it under control, and so it's still Germany in front. You're looking back from the race leader. On the power boost is Portugal, who's a little at the back of this group. He's in fourth place, but he's the one of those. And South Africa and New Zealand fighting for position. They're both on the power boost. And I think
New Zealand down the inside. He's taking the position away from South Africa. New Zealand up to sixth.
Fantastic move by Johnny Reid. Almost had a think about getting past the Netherlands as well. That would have been foolish, and he's backed out of that. But let's see how he did it.
Well, he did it here because it was all done essentially in turn 11. In fact, he got ahead in turn 11. And, well, how come?
Don't know.
Maybe the camera angles were foreshortening what took place. But certainly that pass took place up on turn 11. Not, in fact, as it appeared on screen, down into turn 12.
Well, he was certainly having a go at getting past the Dutch car as well, but it didn't quite happen for him. So it's Germany, France, Canada, then the Portugal. Portugal running absolutely at their best of the season so far. João Urbano, who is coming to the series relatively inexperienced compared to many of the others. He's raced in Formula BMW in both the UK and Germany, but a much lesser powered car than one of these A1 GP machines. But today he's getting it together. But watch him for mental and physical strength. He has made some mistakes in the races in the latter part, so this time he's going to want to try and redress that and keep the pressure on Canada in particular.
Germany can hold a much tighter line through turn 11. France comes in early, goes out, then comes back in again. And it's all about speed off this corner. Now under the rear wing of Germany, France using a sure power boost. It is, goes out to the right, tries to go the long way round. No way this time. Germany's got the corner, France has got to withdraw.
Vitoris is having to withstand so much pressure. So far, so good. He's not put a wheel wrong. But can he do this with 24 laps to go? And another pit stop, remember. And the French team will be desperate to try and make up for what was a slightly slower pit stop on the first round. Canada's just dropped back a couple of car lengths. Can't quite maintain the same pace as these top two nations, which, to be fair, John, have been fast throughout all of the practice sessions this weekend.
And in a moment, for us to catch our breath, Switzerland and Portugal are now under investigation.
Yeah, I don't know what that one's all about, but no doubt we'll find out later on. So, this is the lead situation, and everybody's not quite sure what's going to happen. Still, another pit stop to come. We've completed 29 laps, and the pit stop window will reopen on lap 34. So there's still a few laps to go here before the crews get their chance to influence the race further.
So there's the overhead shot looking at turn 9 again. France, I think France's car is still showing that it's easier to drive. It's a little bit quicker through that turn 9, up into turn 11 now. France runs down Germany, but Germany holds that very, very tight line, which seems to give it the advantage when it comes to the acceleration off the corner. France can close up into it and mid-corner, but doesn't get it on the end of the corner.
That's right, flashing past all the fans down there on that long straight into turn 12. This slightly revised corner, the car's weaving under heavy braking there, not weaving as much as we saw on Friday practice. We've hardly ever seen so many cars spin off the road in dry conditions in the past. But today they're settling down. There've been a lot of incidents early in the race. Now it seems to have just settled down. There's a bit more rhythm to this race now. There's Portugal running in fourth place, Netherlands in fifth. And the Netherlands are the next ones to watch out, because Johnny Reid of New Zealand is beginning to fill the mirrors.
Yes, so Johnny Reid obviously aware that the mistake, whatever occurred on the first lap, where he dropped all the way down from fifth place outside the top 10, and he's been battling all day to get himself back up, to put himself in the position to get back on the podium. He enjoyed that success in the sprint race, an easy race for Team New Zealand, but here a much, much more difficult, and this will really be a great day for Johnny Reid if he can get himself onto the podium. Even if it's only third, he'll be more than happy.
Well, where he is now, having gained that one extra place, he would now be tied with Switzerland in second place in the points if France stays where they are. So each and every point that he can make up here today could make a huge difference. Look how close he gets.
Yes, again, a similar line in the corner to France. Comes in early, lets it drift out, then back in again. Trying to get under the rear wing of the Netherlands car. Netherlands goes to the left to defend. Watch the bumps in the middle of the track now. Watch for Johnny Reid. He's going to go down the outside. It's the wrong part of the track, but he's just keeping the pressure on the Netherlands. Almost side by side into turn 12. He backs out of it wisely too.
Solid defence from Jeroen Bleekemolen, and he's not going to be fazed. He's not going to break too late and make the mistake that Johnny Reid's looking for. Not yet, anyway. And a neat, tidy driver is Bleekemolen, and you don't often see him make rash mistakes, just very occasionally. But he will know how fast Reid is. And when you've got the guy who won the race earlier in the day shadowing you, you've always got to be absolutely on top of your game. And Bleekemolen will be totally aware of that. Johnny Reid, though, all he's got to do is try and push forwards, try and look for any advantage he can, try and use any knowledge, any extra knowledge he can think of at this circuit to gain the edge here through turn seven, accelerating hard through the next fast sequence, through the flat out left-hander where the physical loads really build up.
So come out of turn eight, then the cut back over the bumps through turn nine. Johnny Reid running in sixth place, looking to take that fifth place away from the Netherlands. Sometimes it's better just to drop back a little bit, pick up your momentum and make a charge up. Now there are certain parts of a racetrack where one driver will show an advantage over somebody else. A lot of it could be up in turn 11, a lot of it might come down in the terms of straight line speed and certainly under braking into turn 12. More difficult to do it into turn 12, ironically, I think, than it is into turn 11.
No change amongst the front runners then. At the moment it's still Germany from France in second place, and then Canada with Rob Wickens holding on to that position at the moment. Then the slight gap back to a very impressive Jean Urbano of Portugal, the Netherlands, then New Zealand, South Africa, Brazil. So Brazil inside, and I've got another drive-through penalty, John, being announced, and this time again for Switzerland. And it was for overtaking under safety car. I did wonder why he was moving to the head of that queue, or maybe it was he overtook another car under safety car that he shouldn't have done.
It's hard to tell because we weren't really watching where Switzerland was when the safety car was still on track. I'm not sure he even caught up to the safety car before it was removed from the circuit. Whatever it is, he's also got to go once again in the pit lane. I think it's his fourth visit in the pit lane this afternoon.
Really no chance, I think, of Switzerland scoring any points here today, not with another drive-through penalty. So that's the way it goes sometimes, and he's going to have to just lick his wounds, go away and think about it for the next race at Eastern Creek in Sydney. Just 2 weeks' time, they'll all be hard at it again in Sydney, in Australia. What a fantastic show they've been putting on here so far in New Zealand. No difference really between Germany and France. I wouldn't like to call who's going to win this race at all. We've still got another pit stop to come, and the pit stop window will open in two laps time, so they now have really got to push. They'll both be under instructions. Give it everything you have here, guys, because we want to try and get a bit of an edge for the next pit stop, which is coming up pretty soon.
Well, it's really more about the character of Christian Pretorius than anything else. His physical conditioning, we know, is good. He's not as accustomed to running at this level, at this position. Loic de Val, much more experience, but it will be about character, and as long as he doesn't make a mistake, the onus will be on Loic de Val and for France to force the issue. France have been doing that pretty much all through this event, and Christian Pretorius for Germany has responded and not put a wheel wrong.
Absolutely not. Solid so far, and that's exactly what the team wanted to see from Pretorius. A bit of maturity after a couple of little rash mistakes in his early races for the nation, not getting off the line particularly well, those sort of little errors, but he's done it perfectly so far. There's still some way to go in the race.
Well, further down the field, we've actually seen an overtake. Ireland have found a way past Team USA. They're up now to 10th place in the points, and USA dropped down to 11th.
Right, well, that's a significant move then from Adam Carroll. Let's see if we can find it's a mistake.
Oh, that's why. Just too aggressive on the brakes, runs wide, gets into trouble, and that's... Well, just a very simple move into turn one allows the Irish car to take that position. Thank you very much, Jonathan Somerton. That's the thoughts, I suspect, of Adam Carroll. That's the easiest pass Adam Carroll's probably going to enjoy here this afternoon.
Top three seem even closer as they come over the line this time, because Canada's right up there with them too. There's Switzerland. I think we're still waiting for that drive-through penalty, aren't we?
He's yes. Coming in now.
So he's going to make the drive-through penalty now and drop himself right down to the very back again. What a frustrating day it is for Neil Yarny. It's been a day of a series of success for them so far, but certainly not this one. And the pit stop window's open. We're going to see pit stops next time around.
Interesting, we've now got three cars really covered by under a second. Canada's drawn itself up to the tail of France. Christian Pretorius, maybe he's beginning to feel the heat of the pressure, but it is Rob Wickens who's now going to focus on the back of the France car. France have been relatively lucky that they haven't had to worry about a car behind them. They now have that car, and it's Rob Wickens of Canada.
Now, John, it's going to be the battle of the pit crews once again. Germany won the first round.
Yes, Germany and France are prepared to come in at the end of this lap. Whether Canada will join them or not, or whether Rob Wickens will decide, maybe I can take advantage of the clear air. We saw that with Johnny Reid earlier. Stay out, get the benefit of that clear air. Maybe get one or two laps in before then he will be required also to make that mandatory stop.
Right, watch them. They're heading into the pits after this corner, and try and keep an eye on the two pit stops, see who has the advantage. I noticed that Germany, I was watching... Oh, and France stays out. That is interesting.
Shane, well, France came out in the pit lane. Christian Pretorius kicks up the dust as he comes in. Must slow down. Portugal are in as well, the Netherlands and New Zealand. And they're all pulling up, trying to avoid tipping into the back of one another.
Now, Germany had a fantastic stop. Watch their technique, if we can. Watch the front left wheel man. He'll throw the air gun to one of the guys who runs round from the back of the car. We change our shot now to look at Portugal as we
And
wait.
They're moving. Germany's moving. Comes out. Adam Khan for Portugal. Pakistan allows Germany to come in ahead of it. New Zealand comes out as well. They've had a good pit stop.
Brilliant stop for New Zealand. They've done what they did
and
in China.
France is in trouble.
New Zealand's got ahead of Portugal. That is a massively good stop from Team New Zealand.
I mean, France is out on the racetrack, not in trouble. That was them looking down. So good job for New Zealand and for Germany.
So as we said, they did that in China, did New Zealand, and they've done it again. Now the question is, where will it put them in with regard to France? I don't think Germany's stop was quite as quick that time as it was earlier. Unfortunately, we didn't have the clock running on that one. But France now leads with Canada second. Those guys have decided to stay out there on their older tyres. The thing is, the guys who are now on new tyres should have a little bit of an advantage. Let's see if France and Canada come in this time. I think he is. France heading into the pit lane. Yes, he is. Absolutely. Crucial stop then.
And Rob Wickens for Canada comes in directly behind.
The race deciding moments coming up here. We've got a drive-through penalty for Portugal. Portugal's going to be... Portugal crossed the white line into the pits and they're going to throw away what could have been their best result in a long time. Canada in, France in, crucial stop here. Who's it going to be? Are they going to get out ahead of Germany? We'll watch to see where Germany is on track as well, John.
And watch Canada, it's just gone onto the pit lane, so they're coming down the pit lane, 60 kilometres per hour. France still working on the car. Canada, I think, is going to take a position. France is moving, we didn't see it. France has lost yet again a position. Canada has taken that away from France.
And here's Germany coming down the pit straight. Germany will retain the lead. Here comes Canada, who's got ahead of France, as you say. So Canada will effectively have taken second place. What a great stop from their crew.
So what a change of fortunes. Canada works their way up and after a great pit stop finds themselves in second place. And the battle with Brazil and China, and they're working themselves around with China showing 12th and Brazil in 5th, but that's only because of the pit stop.
And because of New Zealand's fantastic stop, New Zealand is now behind France, and they're effectively running in what is 4th place. So New Zealand have really gained from this round of pit stops, and it means with them only being one place behind France, New Zealand could take the championship lead here. So he might not win the race, but Johnny Reid could take the title lead for the host nation.
Well, the permutations that are available, and we're on lap 36, 16 laps of this race to go, and this race is far from over.
Look at the positions as they stand. This is because South Africa and Ireland and Malaysia have not yet stopped. But Germany then leading those that have stopped. Switzerland not counting them in a way because they've still got to make their pit stop as well.
And we need cooperation from Switzerland from this point onwards. Brazil into the pit, or South Africa into the pit, because of course Neil Yanni not in the race. He needs to be aware that those cars that are battling for not just the podium here but for positions in the championship will look for cooperation from Neil Yanni.
South Africa on way once again, Malaysia too in the background there,
and they're going to come out I think in fifth place just behind the New Zealand car.
Yeah, indeed, and he has rejoined.
So watch France, this is the problem that France had. That's just the end of the pit stop, and there you see
Canada,
that's the difference
through.
Canada just made it ahead.
Indeed, so disappointment for... You remember how fast the French used to be with their pit stops during that first season of A1GP with Nicolas Lafayette and Alexandre Prémat. They won't like having... they seem to have the edge here today, didn't they?
No, well, I think that's been the same, the development of A1GP. Everybody, in every area of the race, be it pit stops, preparation, set up of the car, just the whole effort between year one and year three is transformed.
Well, Ireland lead this race at the moment. They haven't yet made their second pit stop. They've got a clear lead for the moment, but of course we've got to wait for them to come into the pit. So Adam Carroll's enjoying his time out in front.
And his lap times are good. He's running 1 minute 16.1. So the pace of the Ireland car is as quick as anything else out there. Fastest lap still to Germany at 1:15.8. So Adam Carroll basically getting caught in traffic from the beginning of this race. Now he's clear, capable of running quickly.
Battle here between Brazil and South Africa. Brazil slithering down the inside of South Africa. That is for position. China's tucked in there as well. And that was after the pit stop that South Africa made. And there's a smile on the face of Emerson Fittipaldi.
Well, nothing like a racing driver giving that thumbs up to another driver, particularly if he's racing for your nation. Great job by Sergio Jimenez.
You have to feel for Team Portugal, though, John, because that drive-through penalty was simply for crossing the white line, I think, on the way into the pit. And Portugal were on for their best result in such a long time, and I can't believe it. He's now dropped pretty much to the back of the field.
Well, those are the little details a driver has to be aware of. There's no point saying, oh, sorry, guys, I didn't know. I mean, that's part of the preparation, and it's a harsh penalty. It's a never, ever.
Oh, of the people that have stopped, it is Germany that leads this race, with now up there chasing after them Canada. We're riding on board with Team Canada here, but they're tucked in behind Switzerland. That's the problem Canada has. He's not able... Ah, there's Ireland now in from the lead.
And a new fastest race lap, and it's gone to Rob Wickinson. Canada, 1 minute, 15.843. Ireland in. They were running 1 minute 16.1, so they're running close to the pace of the fastest lap. And that was on old tyres. Adam Carroll gets out. Good stop from Team Ireland.
I wonder where this is going to bring Ireland out. It'll be interesting. He may have gained a few places. He's really racing with the likes of Brazil and South Africa. Now, if he could get out in front of Brazil, that would be a huge achievement. I don't think he will quite do it. Let's watch.
Well, they're just coming down, start, finish straight. Now we wait to see where Ireland blends in. Blends in just gets in ahead of Brazil. Yes, he does. Oh. So he's achieved a great score. Team Ireland running a little bit longer before that second mandatory pit stop has paid bonuses and puts Adam Carroll, well, he's going to put him up to seventh place.
But watch Sergio Jimenez, because when South Africa came out in front of him a lap ago, Jimenez used his tyres to great effect and actually got past, didn't he? So Adam Carroll has got to push here, and he is pushing. This is the experience of Adam Carroll. He knows that he has to push hard.
Oh, a little incident down. Oh, Malaysia and Pakistan, and that's the wing, and even further damage. And I mean, talk about heaping, you know, just poor Alex Chung, Malaysia. They've had the worst season in A1GP, and it's just not getting any better. On top of which, the racetrack at turn 12 and 13 once again is covered in dust.
Absolutely.
Australia still running, by the way, despite that earlier pit stop. Here you've got the race leader, Germany. You've got the lapped car of Switzerland in behind, then Canada, then France, then New Zealand. So these are all the... Look how close these front runners are. And Germany not able to really escape the clutches.
And it's been rightly to... I'm just going to say Neil Jani ought to pull over and let this group of four cars get through, and he has done so. And I think that was absolutely correct on the part of the Swiss team to advise Neil Jani, let these four cars go. Do not get involved in their battle. One day, if you did, this may come back and bite you.
That helped Germany a little bit, but what it does mean is that Canada now has a bit of clear air, and with that fast lap a moment ago from Rob Wickens of Canada, there's no denying that this final set of tyres is working well. They may have been able to save a new set of tyres, perhaps, or a virtually unused set of tyres for this final stint. That might have given him the edge of getting fastest lap. Now the best of the tyre is gone. We'll just have to keep an eye on Rob Wickens and see if he can maintain that pace. Right behind him is still France. France running in third place, and now first victory for Loic Duval is not looking quite so likely. The man who started on pole position but also harried Christian Vitoris in the second stint of this race, but the pit stops have really counted against the French team here today, and he's still got to watch out from behind, because there is the Black Beauty. New Zealand with a chance of taking the lead in the title battle here today, and Johnny Reid won't want to throw away an opportunity like that. Then there's the gap back to Ireland, who've done brilliantly with the pit stop there. Great strategy from Team Ireland. It's brought Ireland into sixth position, and remember, they were involved in an incident early on, so that's fantastic. They made an extra pit stop in this race, and yet they're running in sixth place, I think it is. And then the others, fifth place it is now. Fifth place for Ireland, sixth for Brazil, seventh for China, and then in eighth place, South Africa.
And really what's happening, Ireland, they're somewhat 3 and a bit seconds behind New Zealand. The lead of this race, Germany. Germany's running at a slower pace, and therefore the three cars that are behind Germany are also being affected by the German pace. But Adam Carroll running in clear air. New Zealand in fourth place, and he is able to run at the pace he can, well, his own natural pace. And we've got what, 11 laps to go. Let's say within 6 laps, expect to see Ireland closing down on that current fourth place for New Zealand.
Switzerland back out again after yet another visit to the pits, and here France on the inside of Canada almost nearly did it. That was a good attempt by Duval.
Well, that's the part of the racetrack that he's been very, very strong indeed. But of course, if you make the attempt, you lose, and now that's given the advantage back to Johnny Reid in New Zealand. He's, look at the moves on the straight from France, defending one side, then the other. You've got to be careful, because you're allowed to make one defence, but no more. You're not allowed to come back again and defend from the other side of the circuit.
And the same happened ahead.
Look at this, the dust somebody that was
else,
kicked up.
Somebody else had just been off, and Wiggins cleverly there, trying to get the tyres clean.
Exactly, I was just going to say, there's so much dust now on the start-finish straight. Not a problem in a straight line, but when you get to put the brakes on, make the turn into turn one, there could be.
Ireland nearly went too wide into turn one. I was just glancing out of the commentary box window. Carroll saved it. I think he got caught on the dust as well, and it made the car run wide, but he managed to just stay in front of Brazil. That was a bit of a moment for Adam Carroll, having made so much
progress. Just watching Carroll through turn four, he's got opposite lock on. I mean, he's built like a bull. He's the strongest driver, physically the strongest driver, I would say, in A1 GP. And he simply just put the car on his shoulders and dragged it round turn four.
Now, we've got a bit of a radio replay coming up with Team Switzerland. Let's hear what's been going on.
You shouldn't have done that.
Well, he was told he shouldn't have done that. It was obviously Neil Yarny's decision to get out of the way rather than the team's decision.
Well, that's interesting. I would have said the team would have said that, but obviously that was not the case. And he's getting a telling off from his pit wall crew to say you shouldn't have done that. In my opinion, he was right to have done it because this is a race for the podium. And but Neil Yarny running all the way down in 15th place. Well, he's, how many laps is he behind? He's actually, in fact, on the race lap. Nevertheless, that was the judgment that was made by the pit wall, that it was incorrect of Neil Yarny to be so kind.
Well, we've still got a great tussle going on with nine laps to go. There's Ireland, who you just saw in the background, and still little to choose between Canada and France in that battle for second position. A great pit stop by the Canadian team that put them ahead. And remember, Canada and Ireland sharing technical information. The engineers and guys will work together there, and they're both having a pretty good run so far.
Well, Christian Vettors for Germany has got a second or third or fourth wind, whatever it is, because he's managed to pull just over a second of an advantage over Rob Wickens in second place. And we haven't seen that gap. And in fact, it looks like it's a little over a second in the space of, what, five corners. So whether Rob Wickens is struggling, has a problem, or whether it's just Christian Vettors has found something on this run, he's pulling away from second place Canada.
Yeah, he is. Look at France. He loves that tight line into there. China. China was running in seventh place and they're off. Disaster for Frankie Cheng now.
Down at turn seven, the exit of turn seven. Car facing the wrong way. Marshall's once again run to get to that car. But here's the battle for second place. France has a look down the inside. No way. Johnny Reid follows France but decides that his best chance is going to come maybe a little bit later in this race.
Well, demise of China will mean that Mexico come into the points. They were running in 11th place. Now, let's see what happened to China here,
John. Well, he's just very wide in the corner. He gets onto all that very, very fine powder on the racetrack. And that's simply like driving on what you might call it, brown ice.
Well, there's a bit of a look of disbelief down there, isn't there, as China lose a chance to score points. Mexico now in 10th, those of David Garza. The new driver for Team Mexico is only in his second event. He'll be pleased if he can hold it together for the remainder of this race. It also brings South Africa up now to 7th. USA into 8th place. 9th place.
Team Germany under investigation.
Goodness me, now that is news. Team Germany, race leader under investigation by the stewards. What is it for? We don't know yet. We'll find out as soon as we can. But under investigation, suddenly this race takes on yet another complexion.
And in the meantime, Switzerland, who are back on track, having given Neil Yarny a right wigging from the pit lane, has made the fastest race lap by a significant margin, 1:15.114. So Switzerland will go away, I suspect, with 1 point from this feature race.
Team Germany under investigation. We don't know why yet, but he's pulled away in the meantime from Canada and from France. Well, all he can do is just keep pushing and not worry about it. The team probably won't even tell him that yet. They'll be discussing with the race director what the problem is and whether they can try and defend themselves, no doubt. The team manager will be up to see the race director. We may be into a timed race. We are, in fact. It's going to run out of time, this race. We've had the safety car out there, so it's not going to be 52 laps anymore. And there are 4.5 minutes plus one lap to go in this race.
Well, I think we've just about had it all here this afternoon in Taupo, and Switzerland been in and out of the pits for driving issues. Now, we don't know yet the cause of that reason for investigation. Germany, Canada and Ireland all under investigation. So cars running in first, second and fifth place are under investigation.
Well, I was just about to say, could be a chance for Canada, but now they're under investigation as well. So where do we look next? I don't know quite.
Well, maybe Switzerland will win this race by the end of the day.
Well, actually, what it means is that France might win this race yet. Loïc Duvall still might get his first ever win, and he's certainly pushing
and
for it.
And watch, he's getting under the rear wing, coming down the main straight. Canada fans coming to the left of the racetrack. Now Duvall goes out to the right. Can he get far enough ahead under the brakes? He's... Oh, no.
Not quite. That... camera shot sort of foreshortens it. Difficult to work out who's got the edge into the corner, but it is still Canada. Look how New Zealand have closed up, and the fans get a feeling for the fact that Johnny Reid might join in this one now. Look, right in, tucked in behind Team France, and with those cars, or a couple of the cars ahead here, under investigation, in danger perhaps of receiving some sort of penalty, well, of course, that could boost Johnny Reid's chances.
And indeed it will do, because if he signs himself running in second place on the road because Germany and Canada have had to make a penalty, then it's going to be really a shootout in the closing minutes. And it's 2 minutes and 58 seconds of this, which effectively we've got the best part of three laps of this race remaining.
So time's running out here. The clock is ticking away. David Sears must be tense down there at the moment as he waits to see whether Germany is going to hold on, whether Christian Vitoris is going to take his first win in A1GP World Cup of Motorsport, back up that victory that Michael Amermuller had last time out in Zhuhai. But what about Jonny Reid here? He's not given up on a potential podium finish. He won the first race of the day. He wants to be on the podium. He's only got one car to try and get past to achieve that.
Top six cars covered by in total 5.7 seconds, and that was at the last lap, lap 46.
Well, Germany turned into that tricky turn 12 with a useful advantage now over Canada, and if that investigation doesn't give them any kind of penalty, Germany looking quite composed and comfortable for the victory, possibly. 2 minutes, a few seconds, and a lap to go in the race, the feature race here in Taupo. Canada, France, New Zealand all fighting for second place, a gap back to Ireland in fifth position, Brazil holding on to sixth, then South Africa, United States, Australia's come in, a quick pit stop sent him on his way again, USA still up in the points, then the Netherlands, and then the final points holder, Mexico.
Looking back from the Germany car, so down into turn seven under brakes once again, this is on lap 48, and it's 1.5 minutes of this race remaining plus one lap, gap 1.6 seconds to Canada, and a further 0.5 of a second from Canada back to France.
Time ticks away. It's tense stuff here. What is going to happen? Still, the stewards investigating something or other. The team don't even know quite what the problem is. Well, is there going to be a penalty before the end? If they decide afterwards, of course, they can always add a time penalty after the end of the race, so that could cause some confusion.
It's not going to help me in the post-race interviews, that's all I will say.
Well, hopefully they'll have it sorted out when the checkered flag comes out and they'll decide whether there will be one or not. It looks as though Germany's in good shape here. Canada, France, New Zealand, then look at Brazil shadowing Ireland.
Yeah, Brazil coming back strongly. That last lap from Brazil, 1 minute 15.9. Quickest car on the racetrack right now, aside from Switzerland, who yet again increased the lap. There, Switzerland is on a 1:14.679.
Wow!
I didn't think anybody was going to be quicker than the 15-1 that Switzerland already held. He's found a further half second.
Yeah, but he's down out of the points. He's got up 1 point at least, so better not make a note of that, because that'll put Switzerland on 80 points, and it still changes all the points connotations that we've got going on here today. New Zealand still shadowing France, and France, who looked like potential winners earlier on, now not so much. It's going to be so tight here. Still a little bit of time to tick away.
Just looking at Jonny Reid's head as he comes out of turn one, get the feeling he's leaning it back in the side of the cockpit. He's also feeling the pressure, the physical strain, running so close behind a number of cars, having to concentrate on what you're doing at the same time, keep your eyes and nerves aware of what's happening ahead of you.
The clock goes to zero, where we will go on to their final lap when they come past us next time. They'll be given the last lap board, and Germany looking good at the moment, and it looks as though Christian Vitoris is in great shape to take his first win, but he's still got to complete this lap and the next one.
And he's under investigation, yeah. So he might take the checkered flag, but until we know the result of these investigations, we won't be able to declare who is the winner of this race.
The final lap across the line, he goes. It's Germany from Canada, who's managed to escape a bit there from France and New Zealand, and then Ireland in the background. Now, does Jonny Reid take a gamble here? I don't think he should. I think, if anything, he should just hold his position, because New Zealand will take the series lead if he just stays where he is. He's got one of his big rivals ahead of him. He'd love to finish on the podium, but if he stays where he is and everybody else finishes where they are with no penalties applied, New Zealand will be the new leaders once again. They led after the Czech Republic race, where he won both races. They've dropped away just recently, but with Switzerland's problems here today, New Zealand are on target to reclaim the top spot in the championship.
Last time through turn nine on a racing lap for the leaders in this race, Germany, Canada, France, New Zealand and Ireland, followed by Brazil.
Up to the top corner, this long left-hander that leads onto the straight, and it is still looking very good for Germany to really get their campaign going, as Michael Amermuller did at the last event in China. It's going to be, surely now, the 18-year-old who lives near the Nürburgring started his kart racing at the Kirpen racetrack, where Michael Schumacher famously began his career. It is going to be Christian Vitoris, who becomes another new race driver to win in A1GP. It's Germany, who is successful at Taupo as they were last year. Canada takes a brilliant second for Rob Wickens. That's his best ever ever finished, and third goes to France.
And fourth is back to New Zealand, fifth Ireland, Brazil. Top six cars covered by 5.1 seconds.
What a fantastic race all the way to the end, and it's been achieved by Christian Vitores, the man who came into the team. He was such an impressive rookie last year when he drove alongside Nico Hülkenberg, given a race seat chance. He qualified well, couldn't quite deliver the race performances, but crossing the line now, the man who's had the worst weekend, surely, of his season at least, if not his career, 14th place for poor old Neil Jani.
Absolutely, and on top of which he got a fairly public finger-wagging from his crew in the pit lane, telling him not to let those cars go through. I think that was an incorrect judgment or call from the pit wall, that's my view. But a superb driver, Christian Vitores, an outstanding weekend for the German team. They did the work for the feature race, getting on the front row of the grid. I thought the pressure from France initially, to some degree lesser from Canada, would see Christian Vitores maybe not being ready to deal with winning a race with that level of pressure. He's proved me wrong, and he's done a superb job for his nation. And Germany, winners back-to-back, sprint race in Zhuhai, feature race here in Taipei.
They are really back to the sort of form that we saw in season two when Nico Hülkenberg was driving. Hülkenberg loved this Taupo circuit and he dominated the two races. And now Christian Vitores has come along and he has won the feature race here today after an impressive run in qualifying as well. And he deserves a lot of congratulations because he was always under pressure there from Team France in particular, from Team Canada as well. And what about New Zealand? Now they've taken the series lead. Let's just listen to some of the radio communication with Team Germany on that last lap.
Watch
your pit speed,
line up nice and square,
keep it calm. Well, I think that was obviously in one of the pit stops earlier.
Yes, that, now I just wonder, they've had this reference to white lines and are you allowed to cross white lines? I wonder, was that what he did? I wonder, was that the reason why there might have been an investigation? Because three nations, Canada, Germany and Ireland, were all in investigation for the same thing, and you're not meant to cross those lines. Those are pivotal points of the entrance to the racetrack. But what a day for Christian Vitores. Fantastic effort, absolutely superb.
Yeah, and over there to celebrate with his team, who they have delivered today a second place in the sprint race and the win in the feature race, and the German team is on top once again, but this time with a new driver, Christian Vitores. He's been with them a little while, but it's his first victory. Fantastic second place for Team Canada as well, for Rob Wickens, and this guy is a star, there's no doubt about it. He has burst onto the A1GP scene. He's had two podium finishes now already. It is very, very short career. He's only done three events and he's had two podium finishes in that. So well done to Rob Wickens, and well done to Status GP as well, the team that has run that car. Also Team Ireland, who got a good result here today with fifth despite being involved in a little incident earlier in the race. What a great recovery that was by Adam Carroll. And third place, you have to feel for Loic Duval. When is his first win going to come? The guy could not have driven any better than he did. To be honest, he was let down in the pits. There is no other answer for it. If he'd had as quick a pit stop as both Germany and Canada, he surely would have won this race. So the result is Germany winning from Canada and France, but Johnny Reed of New Zealand, a good fourth place, and with a win earlier on today, it's been a great weekend for the host nation. Ireland fifth, Brazil in sixth place, South Africa in seventh, and Jonathan Summerton of the USA picking up more points once again in eighth. Your own Bleekemolen, unlucky, had a spin, dropped to ninth. Mexico's David Garza scores his first point in A1GP. 11th for Pakistan, 12th for the Czech Republic of Thomas Enger. Joao Urbano, again another one of the most unlucky there, that drive-through penalty cost him dear. Switzerland only 14th ahead of those that didn't finish. China, Malaysia, Australia, Indonesia, so many didn't finish this race. Great Britain, Italy, Lebanon, India as well, all failed to finish. The fastest lap though, the one single point, did go to Switzerland. So a race of real drama all the way through there. Highly enjoyable event once again. And both races today have been incredibly exciting, really. I mean, a lot of cat and mouse, not an easy track on which to overtake. You were never going to see a huge number of overtaking maneuvers, but that sort of tactical game. Look at the points. As we said, New Zealand have claimed the top spot now. So it's been a very worthwhile day for the New Zealand team. They're 2 points ahead of Switzerland and France. We have a tremendous three-way tussle going on for the title in season three of A1GP. And look at Germany. They're not too far back either, 15 points behind. They're ahead of South Africa, and Ireland going well, up into sixth place there. The Netherlands behind, Great Britain had a disastrous weekend. They're stuck there on 48 points. They scored nothing here in two races. India also out of luck, so were China. Brazil scored usefully, and Canada in particularly have leapt up thanks to that great result of Rob Wickens. Mexico scoring some more points here today, and David Garza will be given some confidence. The Czech Republic, USA, Portugal, big loser here, I'm afraid. Italy and Australia also there in the points. But, well, in terms of the championship, we really have got the second half of the season beautifully set up now with New Zealand and that two-point advantage over Switzerland and France. All three nations capable of winning races, as we've seen already this year. And, well, there's no way of knowing where this title's going to go with the events still to come in Sydney in just a couple of weeks' time, and then in Durban in South Africa. We're going to Mexico as well, to Shanghai, and of course in May we'll end it all at Brands Hatch in Kent in the UK. And I think the title's going to go all the way to the wire this time. If France and Germany might have won their respective titles relatively quickly before we got to the final race, at least, of the season, it could be a different story this year. Up onto the podium they come then, and it's Christian Vitoris. Look at him, look what it means to him to have taken his first win in A1GP. Second place coming up to receive, well, in a moment, his medal, Rob Wickens of Canada. That's his best ever result. And, almost matching Canada's best ever result. They've had one victory in their time in A1GP. And Loic Duval settles for third. Oh, you have to feel, as I say, for him, though. The shoulders are down a little bit. There's a glum look on Loic Duval's face. He had the pace. He drove beautifully. But two pit stops that weren't the best. And he lost first the lead, and then he lost second place as well. He could not have pushed any harder than he did, but ultimately he was to be denied. So the trophy awarded by the Right Honourable Helen Clark, Prime Minister of New Zealand. And Loic, two third places today, very useful points. And just looking at that points table, it means that France are very much there and in contention. But what he wanted more than anything today was his first victory. The silver medal goes to Rob Wickens of Team Canada. And this guy really has shot onto the scene. There's no doubt about it. The Canadians have found a new star here. He's raced primarily in North America up till now, and we're going to see a lot more of him, I think. But it's Christian Vitoris who receives the gold medal, and Team Germany on top. Rob Creswell with a big smile on his face, the race engineer. What a day this has been for him. Second in the first race, these guys. And now the win in race two. And as we had last year, Germany winning in New Zealand. And we're going to hear the German national anthem once again here at Taupo. What an exciting time it is for German drivers coming through, and another member of the Willy Weber stable. We saw what Nico Hülkenberg did last year in A1GP, and now they've got another one, Christian Vitoris. There's Michael Amemuller as well, who did so brilliantly in China a few weeks ago. And, well, Michael Schumacher may have retired from Formula 1, but you have to say the Germans have plenty of other young, talented drivers who would love to take over that role, and maybe they will. Certainly a brilliant effort today by Christian Vitoris, and he's going to enjoy his moment there on the podium, spraying the champagne. So our top three.